Hi everyone. I thought I would take this beautiful sunny autumn day here in St. George, Ontario, Canada to show you my personal fleet of human-powered snowplows. These are the same machines that were featured on the Discovery Channel recently, so I thought I'd bring them out here in the sunshine before the snow flies and let you have a little better look. This, of course, is the trike that started it all. When I was rebuilding it, I noticed it had a split rear axle. It was driven by two chains, which gave it somewhat of a positive traction rear end, and that got my imagination flowing to think, hey, this thing would be really good in the snow because the one wheel slipped, the other one still have traction. So I come up with this snow plow idea. It's a simple ABS pipe, forks off a bicycle, just lifts and follows the contour of the ground. That's a little small plow because you can't push a lot of snow. Any excess snow just flows over top and you take another run at it and move it. Very aerobic workout, and certainly easier on the back. Now this here is my Blade Runner ice bike. And this was a bike that won a lot of races for me. And when we were outside on the outdoor tracks, of course it would snow occasionally, and we'd be out there shoveling the snow. And this is kind of crazy. I got a machine here with excellent traction on the ice. Why don't we, you know, put a snow plow on this one? So I got the idea of a belly plow, like you would have on a grader. Again, some ABS pipe, some metal rod attached to the front cross member, quick release so I could take it off before the race. But during or before the races and between each race, I would take a run on the track and clean it off. So that saved us a lot of shoveling. Now this is a multi-speed machine, so I could drop it into low gear and that would give me the torque to move as much snow as I could, depending on the snowfall. It worked really well. And this, of course, is the pedal quad. Very comfortable, much larger and heavier. I acquired this used and I modified the seating to accommodate a full-size adult. I then changed the gearing, lowered it down, and then spent the rest of the time developing this fully articulating plow. So it turns left and right, lifts up, and all the controls are accessible from the seat here. Now this is a little heavier, but it does move more snow. You can use that speed and inertia to push a lot. In the future, I plan on changing the rear end and the gearing, make that more universal. But for the meantime, this is quite a nice machine. I do like the quad design for its stability. Much more stable than the tricycle over there, which is high up. So it's like a semi-recumbent design. And then we move over to my recumbent trike here. My Terra trike that I just acquired for riding in the winter so I wouldn't be slipping, sliding, and falling down on the ice and snow. And it's really nice. And again, the idea came to me, like, why don't I put a plow on this to do my driveway when I got just a few inches of snow? So very much like the ice bike, I used a belly pan idea. Down below, ABS pipe running on conduit, electrical conduit tubing. And simple attachment using clamps that are actually from a fence post. If you know a chain link fence, the little straps they use to hold the chain link fence are wrapped around that front cross member just nicely. So that's a simple attachment. And just a little upgrade over the ice bike, I used a friction shifter here to raise and lower the plow so it's not always drag. So that's fun. The plow is fixed for just one direction, which is fine. It clears all the chains, as you can see. So that was the latest addition. So there's my fleet ready for this winter. Hope you enjoyed this.